done. I already primed my face, and I already have some moisturizer on. This is the Olaplex Vitamin Plus, without any oils in it. Because, like, yeah, you know. And then I used the Professional. Then I took some of the Master Strobing Liquid on my finger, just like this. And I'm just tapping it on my nose and on my cupid's bow, like this. If you don't like the light, comment down below. But I kind of like natural lighting. Look at that shine though. Then I'm going to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit in Light. And I'm going to take the Light Sculpting Shade. And I'm going to use it to sculpt my face. You probably know how this works. So I don't know why I'm talking so much. I'm sorry about that. So yes, I'm gonna use this one. So I'm just taking that shade and just contouring with using a, my dad called this a toothbrush and I got like really mad. But I'm using an artist brush in the shade in the form of a, if you're wondering why I have like bags that is just so dark, it did something wrong today, and I'm not proud of it, but I did something wrong today, and then I paid for it, so now I have really dark room samples. So that's too dark. Okay, so I'm going to take some prep and prime on my brush, because that just makes it a whole lot better to get out. And kind of more payment to do, but we don't care about that. At least I'm right now. Leave that bit of head of your nose and a little bit on the forehead. I'm not a big fan of forehead contouring, but I'm doing it anyways. Okay, so then I'm gonna continue. Okay, so I blended some of my Estee Lauder foundation with some of my shade adjusting drops, and it got a little messy, but we'll fix that. I'm using my artist brush and I'm just gonna pat it on in the first place, then we'll just rub it down, and then down the next. That's really important, you know. Really important. Don't get it in your hair. That's important too. And you're cover up the contour. Okay, so this is important, alright? Listen here. So I have like noticed that people like right now, so I am applying foundation, like I don't really want to, right? But I am noticing that that a lot of people ain't doing that anymore. That became real wrong. Okay. So I'm noticing that a lot of people don't really care how they apply their foundation no more, because they think everything is right, but no. And I'm not saying I'm right, but I'm obviously not. Today I became right. Donald Trump became the leader of the entire world. That's not happening soon, if I have something to say about it. But I've been noticing that a lot of people don't really care how they apply their foundation and how much they use, and like, you know, right now I'm trying to match my neck, not happening, but I'm trying at least, and some people don't do that. As my friend said today, foundation is really important to match, because if not, you have a mask on you, that's not really good, and I know you can't really see. I'm gonna try so you can see a little bit more. No. Okay, so, but, like, I did my brows now, right? But since they were, like, a little bit wrong for me, I am trying to fix it with putting foundation on top. I have this pimple there. So annoying. But I can't do anything about it. So, yes. I'm gonna use my beauty blender, and I'm just gonna try to fix up a little bit of this mess I just made. Better, much better. Oh, that's okay. Alright, so now I'm just gonna remove the foundation. So now I'm just gonna use the Naked Skin Concealer underneath my eyes and on the area I want highlighted. Because this is really light. It's as light as the day is light. I don't know. I'm not a poet or anything like that. So I'm just making a triangle underneath my eyes and making it go up. And I'm trying to not have a lot of concealer underneath my eyes, because then it just looks cakey AF. So I'm trying to like strobe a little bit. I've never been the one to strobe, but I'm trying today. If you're wondering about the bumps on my chin and on my forehead right here, I have some bumps right here, and that's because I have like pimples that haven't grown out yet, so they form like bumps on my skin, and that's not good to know that, but I don't really know what to do, so I'm just waiting for them to pop out by themselves. So I'm doing this, today is Thursday morning, the 9th week, but I'm uploading this on a Monday, so you might wonder if I'm wearing the same t-shirt. If you know me, yes I am. It's called a washing machine. I don't really care about what. I'm filming like 7 things today. I can't I cannot change every time I'm filming a video. That would not be good. Would it now? No, it wouldn't. Okay, so I'm gonna close this up. And I'm gonna come back to you in a minute. So now I'm going to bake my under eyes. If I can find a sponge, I'm going to use two Real Techniques baby sponge, I think. Hopefully, this is, of course, the Laura Mercier translucent powder. And in. It doesn't say anything. So I don't know. I just have some. put it inside of the cap right there. I'm just gonna bake. Okay, so now I have taken on the powder. Where you want to bake is normally up to yourself, but sometimes you should focus more on some parts. Like me, for example, I itch my nose all the time, so I really need to bake there so that the powder don't go away. Then you have to bake underneath your eyes so that the concealer doesn't crease. Then maybe between your brows and in your smile lines, because then you don't get creasing there either. And when you are finished with your contour, you can do it there too. I'm going to show you. Just wait a second. So I just recently bought this, which is the NYX Highlight and Contour Pro Palette. This is in the shade HCPP01. So yeah. So there are 4 highlight setting powders, and then there are 4 contour powders. Now, what I usually do, you don't have to do it if you don't want to. I usually use like a fluffy brush, like, so let me see if I can find it. Like this one, like this, which is actually meant for blush, but I don't really use blush that often, so I'm going to use this for that. And I'm gonna mix every shade to just so that the brush looks a little bit dirty, you know. I'm gonna sit the very counters there. So like this. I don't know. I'm just gonna hold it. Now I want person needs to contour with it. So yeah. So then you just contour where you need to. You don't need to as much as I do, usually do, I mean, but yeah. Don't do what I do, alright? I'm trying to figure out. Yeah, you can kind of see it when I don't have as light on me, but yeah. No, I don't like it, but I love, no, I'm just gonna dip a little bit of foundation on there, and I'm going to go with this brush, because this brush I actually like. This is the Bare Minerals ID brush, which isn't meant for contouring, but yeah, I'm gonna just use this shade now. It's the lightest shade of them all. I'm just gonna contour. You probably know what I'm gonna do, but I'm gonna say it anyways. Something is really patchy and I don't think it's gonna wet. I just pounded it there. How can it be patchy? I don't understand. I don't understand. I'm just gonna take some powder and dust it all over my face so I do not do this again. One more. I usually contour, so it's easier for the contour to stick on. You can see I do have a contour there already. Okay, I'm gonna try this again once more. I'm just gonna get a little to the palette and I'm gonna try to contour. Oh, good. Please work. No, please. It's better. Not good enough. Better. So on the other side, hopefully this goes well. No, that's not bad at all. That's good. Actually good, yeah. But this side, it looks like crap. Okay. But I think I'm gonna need to work about myself up a little bit more. It's gonna into the pose again, but I'm gonna use two of the shapes this time. I'm just gonna wander a little more, bronze the face a little bit more, just a bit under my cheek. Yes, ta-da. So now I want to show you the trick I talked about. That you take a sponge and you dip it in setting powders or whatever you want. It's something or someone. And you do it still like that. You can see that line, I hope. Yeah, okay, you can. Yeah, good. But I'm gonna do it here as well. Because I can see where the contour ends. And I'm gonna do it on the entire contour. Because I don't like it on that side. But on this side, I actually think it is perfect. I'm just gonna fix it up a little bit more. So, like that. Then you can also contour down here. So that's what you need to do. Okay, so now I'm gonna take a brush. And I'm just gonna brush away the things under the eyes. No, I'm not. Sometimes I just like to talk to myself. Yes, I do kind of. No, not really, but sometimes. And I'm also kind of weird, so that's fair too. Yeah. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to try a new palette that I just bought. This is the Smashbox Cover Shot Smoky Eye Palette, which is this thing right here. And just look at the packaging though. Huh? Okay, so this is how it looks inside. It's really beautiful colors. I don't know if you can see them. Yeah, there. Okay, so there's really beautiful colors inside. Really beautiful. And I love them. I really love them already. I haven't tried any of them yet. So what am I gonna do now? Okay, so I'm just gonna do something. So I prime my eyes using the MAC Soft Off Group Paint Pot. Everybody knows it. So yeah. Before I do anything else, I'm gonna brush away the bandage, which is a big fail on that side. Looks so weird, but on this side it's good. And in between my brows, I'm gonna take it away. And I'm working my nose and everywhere except underneath my eyes, because I'm gonna use that for later. So, yeah. I'm gonna take this brush from Zoeva, and it is the gold. Rose Gold Collection, and it is the Luxe Classic Shader Brush. And I'm gonna open the palette, and I'm just gonna set my primer, and I'm gonna use the light shade called Feature. I'm just gonna, pigmentation, come through. I know, I stole that, but I wanted to say it right. Sorry, yeah. No, I stole that tone. I want to say it, so boy. I'm gonna say it here with me. I'm not gonna do that, but I might. You don't know that. I have some blue, I have some grey, I have some purple, I have some pink, white color. Because like my hair isn't, you know. Okay. So then I'm gonna use the green shade. I'm gonna go in with a fluffy blender brush. Now I'm gonna go with the Luxe Eye Blender from Suewa, and I'm gonna take the dark brown, not dark brown. I don't know why I'm not using that mirror. But yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna take it into my crease. Just like that. Come through pigmentation line. Just like this. I'm only gonna use this palette. Just okay. And we're gonna wing it. Little bitlet. Bara vingarna lite grann. Oh, I don't know what to use. But, Howard, so what are you gonna do? You know, I love the contour, but not to that side. I don't like it on that side. Yeah. Gonna do some more. Okay, so then I'm gonna take the dark thing right there. I'm gonna create some shadow. You will see that in a while because I forgot his name, so that's just fine. Alright, so I'm gonna take a, if I can find it, that will be great. No? Huh. So I'm gonna take a flat brush and I'm gonna take the really, really nice green and take it all over my eyelid, mainly focusing on the outer edges. You can't see. Can't see that, but I'm trying, okay. I'm gonna try something, okay, just I hope that's working a lot better. So now I'm just gonna continue, but I'm gonna squeeze some Fix Plus on it because I didn't really see the pigmentation coming through. So I'm just gonna do a little bit rerunning. And if you're wondering why my leg is so weird, it's mostly because I'm weird, but not, yeah. Not too weird, hard to say. Yes, okay. So I'm just gonna take the, what do you call it? Rock Me. I think that's Rock Me, the green one. I'm just gonna pop it all on my eyelid, not blocking you or anything. Oh my god, look at that. That's beautiful. I know the pigmentation is bad eyes, but I. That's just beautiful. Alright, so now I'm just going to move on to my next step, which is whatever I want it to be. So I'm going to take the, I'm going to turn over my brush like so, and I'm going to take the zero color lightly on my brush. I'm just going to pat it in my inner corners, because I don't want that dramatic of a look. Not in my inner corners, by the way. Like that. So, if you do not worry if you get it, like, not on the just like that, I will fix that afterwards. But look at that contour, though. Never done that good at contouring me. Yes, I do. Which was. Now I'm going to do the exact same on the other eye. So I'm going to pause here and I'm going to come back. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go into this part right here, which is from MAC, which I did same myself, which I don't know if they sell this in MAC, because I know they did disappointed by myself, not by MAC. Alright, so I'm going to take the green shade, whatever what you think. Yes, the green shade. And I'm going to take it all over my eyeline just to give it a more of a popping color. This is more like a lime green color than the one I used before. It's more of a pale color, so I don't know. I guess both is okay. So you like that. And I know you can't really say what I'm doing here, but you wait and say, yeah. You wait and say, you wait and say, you wait and say. So I can see me in front of me. And I think it looked pretty, but you don't see the same as I do. So, you know, I kind of like to look at this and not like no body. I'm gonna start talking now. I'm gonna dry out this. Okay, here we go. And just give me some Okay, yeah, I think you look pretty. You may not see the same as I do, but I think you look pretty, and that's what matters. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put on some lipstick, I think. Maybe want to gum it up a little bit more. I'm not really sure yet. I need some highlight. I want you. I pick the. I kind of have to press this again, but Mary Luminizer. I cracked this, or my friend cracked this, and I heard to fix it, so I did. Okay. You can see that time. I can't. I had to play it for a bit far. It was cold. I hope you can do that. Yes, you can. Pretty troubles to keep it far. Look at that glory. Love. Like, it looks messy for you guys, but for me, it looks so pretty. Look that highlight on Fleet Dye. So I have this tape right here where I keep some of my favorite lipsticks. I'm gonna actually show you through them. So this one is starting to look a little weird, but I'm gonna take you out of it anyways. So here are the Red Passion from L'Oreal. I'm not gonna wear you today. I think that would look weird. This is Titanium Rubies. I like dark colors. You may have already know that. And this is nice. So this isn't, it's like, that, no, that is not bad at all. Not for me, at least. And then I have MAC lipsticks. I have Sin World. So Good For You and Please Me. So I'm going to show you. This is Whirl, and it is a brownish color. This is Sin, and it's a really very dark color. This is You're Too Good For Me, which is a, it is a dark color. It is a color. And then there is Please Me. So I'm not really sure what I want to take on today. I think I'm gonna go for my new Maybelline, which I didn't show you, so that's too bad, I guess. I don't know. But this is in the shade Nude Embrace. I'm not one for nude colors because I love color. So I'm gonna go for nude. I'm wearing like this weird eyelock, but like, why not? You know, why not? So I'm just gonna take it on. Oh my god, that's pretty. I never ever owned a Maybelline lip place before this one. That's kind of sad now. You haven't seen that before, but I do now. So that's kind of sad. I'm like, hello. Kind of like overlining my lips a little bit too much. Love it. It feels so great. Okay, so now I'm finished with the look. Too bad you really can't see it, but I'm finished anyway. But I need to do the lower lash line. I'm gonna go back into this thing. I'm gonna take this brush right here, which is from Better, and I'm gonna take the brown shade. What did that happen to you? No glow dark. So I'm just gonna apply that to the lower lash line. Need some color. The lower lash line too, you know. I'm gonna try fixing it a little bit. Like that. Being a little bit there. Like that. And then doesn't look too bad. It looks too bad there. But not in real life. What I need. Sorry. Too bad for you. My life is not bad. Or, so this is too bad. Okay. So I'm going to try a little bit more. I need a teacher. Since I obviously didn't think this look was not bad enough, I'm gonna get a little bit dark with this look. I'm gonna take my mirror and I'm gonna do a little line. I'm just gonna do crazy thing. Just gonna do a little line. To make a kind of a wing, if you want to call it that. Anything I'm gonna call it that. Okay, if you want to, I don't really care. And if you want to. Again, if you want to. You can if you want to. Okay, I should be doing that. That's a little long for me to. I'm doing a really good job at this. I don't think. Now that it's complete, if I lose the camera, I think it's so stable. What is that? I don't know if I do ask him. I go for Tavin. The highlighter is not. Yep. The highlighter is not. Then you're the mellow. And you're in the lot. Then for final touch, I'm going to highlight a little bit more using Champagne Pop by Becca, or not yet, kind of Becca, but not really. So this is kind of pinky turned, but I love it. Oh, it was so great. But it is beautiful though, so yeah, I love it. Love. So then my thing is finished here. I have to put on some mascara, I think. Yeah, we put on some mascara. I kind of feel like I should curl my lashes this time. So I don't want to tell anyone. So this is like the darkest I look I've done ever on my channel, and it took 40 minutes. Like, I never do anything for 40 minutes. So that's kind of amazing. Anyway, when the ads are in the corner, so I can have a rain bottom. So I'm going to use the FH Norway Hybrid. So this highlight underneath my brows a little bit. So then I'm going to say, use my curlies, my splitter new curlies. If you don't know what splitter new petite, it means brand new. Yes, I'm going to